Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Praxis 5572 channel. Welcome to my kitchen. I want to make something very delicious today, and it's going to be quick, it's going to be easy, and it's going to be delicious. If those three things are not in order, I'm not making it. And those three things fell right in line today. So I'm going to make something really fast, really easy, and really delicious for you. And it starts out with, I don't know, what the heck? It starts out with a plant. I don't see why not. This is called a miracle fruit plant. And a miracle fruit plant basically produces a small fruit that if you eat it, you can eat a pickle, you can eat a lemon, you can eat a lime, just bite right into it. And you normally wouldn't do that because, you know, you're going to have this little stroke thing going on. But if you eat one of these fruits first, chew it up really good, and then bite into this, it tastes sweet as candy. That fascinated me. So I ordered some seeds and I grew this miracle fruit plant. One of these days, one of these years, this little booger is going to put out fruit, and I am going to demonstrate it on the Voodoo Garden channel. If it works, it's going to be a miracle. If it doesn't work, you are in for a treat because you're going to see me bite into a lemon, a big honking bite. And this is actually making me cringe as I think about it. You're going to see me bite into this thing and have a stroke right there on camera. Ooh, a seed. I'm going to make strawberry pie for you today. That's what I'm going to do today. And I'm going to start with something that is my favorite in the garden. One of my favorites. Actually, no, let's face it. It's my favorite. Strawberries. Fresh grown strawberries. Absolutely delicious. The smell, when you smell them in the grocery store, insane. I mean, it draws you right to them. Out in the garden, nothing is better than walking up to your strawberry patch and seeing this big red ripe strawberry right before the robins get it. Well, I have 4 cups of strawberries. Actually, I'm going to list all of the ingredients in the description below the video. It's not very many ingredients, so it'll be very simple for you to make. If you want to make a pie and you want to make something fresh and spring-like, this is definitely the one for you. First, you're going to need a pie crust. I bought this at the store because I suck at making pie crusts. I don't like doing it. I can do it. I just prefer not to. These were cheap. Get yourself a pie crust. Bake it in the oven. You want a pre-baked pie crust. Take that. You take the strawberries. Toss in the strawberries. Yes, toss in the strawberries. And try not to eat a half a cup of them beforehand like I did. I ate a lot of these when I was getting the video ready to film. I couldn't help myself. Strawberries are one of the things I absolutely, positively cannot resist. If I thought I could get away with it, I'd be eating these things in the store. And yeah, but you can't be doing that. I know some people do, but you're not supposed to. Okay, you know what? I just happen to have, oh my gosh, a spare pie crust. Where did that come from? I think I have enough to make 2 pies. Why not? The only thing better than 1 strawberry pie is 2 strawberry pies. Now what I'm going to do is take about 2/3 of these and toss them into the pie crusts. Let's even this out. You know, you can just make one of them, of course, but I like to make a spare whenever I make pies because, you know, making a pie is not something that you just like open up a can and it's there. Well, I guess if you have pie filling, you could do that. But generally, it's something that I have to work on a little bit. So I want to make sure that I have enough to make it worth my while. Okay, strawberries are tossed in there. How simple was that? I mean, seriously, how simple was that? Let's set that aside. Now, we take the rest of the strawberries. Oh, I just happen to have a pan right here. Toss the strawberries into a pan. Set the dish aside, and eventually that thing's going to be miraculously washed, and you're not even going to see it again. That's what happens. You know, on the cooking shows, you see these people putting the dishes over there and you wonder, what the heck ever happened to those? Somebody has to wash them. Well, yeah, I have a roommate who washes dishes. Oh, and you don't normally need this, but I was at the grocery store and I bought this. You know, you don't go into the grocery store hungry. Ooh, bad idea. Anyway, I love lemons. I don't eat them raw, but I love lemons in just about everything. And I thought, the recipe doesn't call for this, but why not, huh? So take a lemon, cut it in half, squeeze it into the pan. By the way, that was about maybe 2 cups of strawberries and 1 cup of sugar. Now I'm going to squeeze this lemon very carefully so as to not get any seeds in here. Just get the juice of half a lemon. Make sure the seeds don't go in there because seeds taste awful. And plus, if you're like me, you're going to plant these suckers after the video's over. Yep, I love growing my lemon trees. I have like, I think 1 or 2 now, and they are fun. Anybody that's grown a lemon tree, you know how much fun those things are to grow. So save your seeds. Okay, half a lemon, done deal. All we have to do now is toss this on the stove, turn on the fire without blowing ourselves up. And then, while that's heating up, you take 1 cup of water, you throw in 3 tablespoons of cornstarch, mix it all up. You know what? I was supposed to actually pour the water into the bowl. I had this all rehearsed. But once I get to talking, I really can't think. I cannot multitask. I can talk or I can think. I can't do both. Anyway, whisk it up. Mix it up like that. And you know what? Ooh, my hands smell like lemons. I kind of like that. Let's get us a spoon. What we're going to do is heat this up on a low heat. While this is heating up on a low heat, don't be tempted to do it on a high heat. Otherwise, you're going to burn the sugar. And although it may smell good, ain't good for your pie. I'm going to heat this up on the stove on a low heat, set this aside, the cornstarch mixture, and the second half of the lemon, I just can't resist. This has got to be good. I'm going to, ooh, another seed. Normally, you don't like seeds, but if you're a gardening fanatic addict like me, you love the idea of getting free seeds. And bonus, squeeze the other half. Here, squeeze the other half. Here, and you might think, ooh, that's going to be sour. No, it's not. That's what sugar's for. Sugar makes everything better. Okay, we're going to set these aside. Come on over to the stove and let's finish this off. That's how easy it is. In our saucepan, we have 1/3 of our strawberries and 1 cup of sugar. Heat it up on a low heat and stir frequently until you get this liquid. The sugar and strawberries will mix together and form this strawberry juice, which is, oh, the smell. I cannot even describe the smell. You gotta try this. You really do. But as far as chopping up the fruit, a lot of recipes will tell you to use whole strawberries or just cut them in half and use large chunks. That looks beautiful. It looks beautiful when you pile them on and make that beautiful pie, but I go for practicality. To fit more strawberries into the pie with less air gaps, I chop them up, slice them up, and chop them up, and that way I can pack them into a pie, and also I get more of them in here and they break apart, because what we're doing is we're heating this up so that we can dissolve these strawberries a little bit and bring out the flavor and form a juice, basically a sauce, to pour into the pie pan. So I prefer to cut them small. It's really up to you. Large or small, it really doesn't matter. It's a strawberry pie. It's going to be delicious no matter what. So let's get this up to a nice simmer and then we'll add our cornstarch. We've cooked this for about maybe 10 minutes. It's starting to simmer. Let's pour in the cornstarch. Pour it all in at once. And then just stir slowly and cook it until it thickens up. Once the mixture heats back up, it thickens really quick. So you want to keep stirring it gently. Smash up the rest of those strawberries. Oh, the smell is beautiful. This is going to be a great pie. This is going to be a really good pie. Keep stirring it. Cook it, I don't know, maybe 5 minutes after it comes back up to a bubble. Cook it for about maybe 5 minutes. That activates the cornstarch. You don't want to just add it in there and then pour it into the pie. You want to simmer it for a little bit so it bubbles. That'll help thicken it up, and that's what we want. We want it to thicken up here, and then when we pour it into the pie and put it in the fridge, it'll stiffen up and be a nice, solid strawberry pie. It's going to be great. Our thickened filling is finished. Let's pour it into the pie pan. Nice and gentle. Don't glob it in, just pour it in nice and easy. Spread it around, and it'll sink in with the fresh strawberries. After we pour it in, we just kind of move it around, push it towards the edges, and make sure it gets in there with the fresh strawberries. This way, when we put it in the fridge and it chills and sets up, we're gonna have a mixture of delicious filling with the creamy texture of the cooked strawberries, the sweetness, mixed in with the fresh crunch of the fresh strawberries. Okay, it took about maybe an hour in the fridge and this pie set up perfectly. It holds together beautifully. I took a little bit of whipped cream and put it around the edge because I like whipped cream. And by the way, when this is, oh, hold on a second. You know what it tastes like? It tastes like happiness. Strawberries are fantastic. I mean, if you haven't ever had a strawberry pie, if you like strawberries, this is absolutely the way to go because you get the crunch of the fresh strawberries, you get the creamy texture and the enhanced strawberry flavor from the cooked strawberries, and a little bit of whipped cream and a nice flaky crust. This is fantastic. This is fantastic. And I hope you do try this because in spring, when strawberries are in season, when you're growing them, or at the grocery store when they're dirt cheap, this is the perfect thing to take those extra strawberries and make your pie. And by the way, if you want to save the pie for later, all you have to do is take the pie, set it in your freezer uncovered. You can even put the whipped cream on it. Put it in the freezer uncovered. Let it set for maybe about 2 hours. Take it out, put some plastic wrap over it, wrap it really good, and then throw it in your freezer, and this thing will save for months and months and months. So you can have it literally that following fall. Yeah, I've frozen pies forever. You can have it that fall when there's no strawberries to be seen anywhere on earth, and you're having a fresh strawberry pie, because when you take it out of that freezer and you thaw it out, you don't even have to heat it up. You thaw it out, you have a nice cool strawberry pie on an autumn day. It just brings back spring. It absolutely brings back spring. It makes you feel really good inside. No matter when you have strawberries, it's a very good day. So anyway, thank you everybody for joining me for my strawberry pie recipe. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you try it yourself. Have a great day, everybody. This is Ray on the Praxis 5572 channel. Talk to you soon. This is so good. I like me some strawberry pie. Oh yeah.